be in the moment and react and see what happens. So in a way, we're not in control of it. And I think the relationship at 12 is really complicated, and I like that. And you know, regeneration wasn't an easy thing, and I think that's what Stephen really wanted to address. It's like, you're not just gonna go, oh hey, best friend, do you have a new face? Anyway, should we go adventure? It was like, it was complicated, and dealing with the change in that person, I felt like we really explored regeneration, I think. Was that the question? Did I answer that?
Well, I think you did. Yes, I have a couple more, so
okay.
Yeah. One of the tipping points, I think, our Paul's relationship was at the end of Kill the Moon.
Yeah, that was a big argument, right?
Yes, when you launch into this impassioned speech.
She was very angry.
She's almost frozen, you know. She's past the point of violence.
Yes.
Where she thinks she's gonna lash out, but she's so much afraid. How much of that is directing, scripting, and your own performance role?
It was an amazing script, a really, really great script, and it was a tense episode, and quite a dark episode, and quite a, I think it was the culmination of the regeneration and of this doctor no longer behaving like the person that she used to know. I think it was the culmination of all of that for her, and actually feeling abandoned in that moment, and that's never happened before. She's suddenly not, she didn't feel safe, I think, for a moment. So I think it had been building for like the 6 episodes, and then all came out in that big, big wrap. But it was really great writing.
Samuel Anderson, of course, played your love interest really.
He did. He's in cyber heaven right now.
Yes, he is. Flying around.
Yeah. My boyfriend's in cyber heaven.
I never would say that.
Exactly.
How was it that sort of bringing him into this this new doctor companion relationship? Like, there's sometimes some, like, relationships on screen. I don't think it's on screen, perhaps. Maybe he was always thinking, like, he's elbowing in on you and Peter's relationship as doctor companion.
Say that one again.
I'm just wondering if sometimes, perhaps, Samuel Anderson sort of felt like he was elbowing in on the relationship that you and Peter Cavalli
was. Well, he was never a traveling companion. So much of that series was the Clara split between her Earth life and her space life, and kind of trying to do both, really unsuccessfully living a double life. So he was obviously much part of the Earth life. I think Clara is a bit selfish with the TARDIS. I think she quite likes it over the Doctor.
One thing I do want to ask you, because I interviewed Rachel Calloway, front episode of Last Year's Trial Fields in this year. And there's a scene when you're throwing the keys in the lava.
Yeah.
And she said that you were upset because they shot Peter's scenes on the last day of the one film they had filming. And then your scenes.
Yeah.
The first scenes of the next day. And you were upset about, you felt that you gave your better performance reading lines to Peter as opposed to actually doing your own scenes. I mean, do you get frustrated when you feel that your past performances are not being captured on
film? I think it was just one of those scenes that had unfortunately been scheduled over 2 days. And I think sometimes when you, and especially an emotional scene and an important scene like that, you find it when you pick it up on its feet and you start doing it. So then when you go home and go to sleep, the morning after, you're trying to get something back. And I think that was the way, it's just one of those things. It's the way it goes, you know. It's just the way when you're shooting your schedule, that sometimes happens.
It works.
Yeah.
The scenes made on screen are pretty good.
Yeah, it's a really good scene.
Yeah. So in the Christmas special, last Christmas, was it actually originally written then that you were going to leave as old Clara? That an answer? Because Stephen Moffat, we're getting back to that again. Stephen Moffat said that he had written it to end as that, and then wrote the little coda where the doctor travels back. And you're young again.
We decided during the world tour to do another season.
Would you have felt comfortable if you had left at the end of that Christmas special?
I think it would have been unfinished. There was more stories to tell. It wasn't done yet. It wasn't time, but it was just more stories to tell. There was more to do, and I don't think I could have walked away with it feeling unfinished.
We're not going to delve into spoilers, but for the series now, it's for 2 episodes. Yeah. what was it like? It was almost like two-parters. And it's a longer, there's part stories, they're not like as cut and dry as 45-minute episodes. Did that change the production of anything apart from making it a little longer?
It gives you 90 minutes to be able to go to a planet and explore the characters and tell a story. It gives you the opportunity to have cliffhangers, which is great. So I think it really worked, because 45 minutes to go to a planet, meet the bad guys, tell the story, is not very long in setup, really, and to also explore the characters that we meet. So to have 90 minutes to do that time is also really great. And cliffhangers are just brilliant, and I think Stephen's got some brilliant ones this season.
This isn't a spoiler because it's been all over the place that Missy is back for at least part of the series. Right? What was it working with Michelle Gomez again after ending the last series and then starting the new series with her?
She is brilliant. Yeah, she's absolutely bananas. You do not know what she's going to do take to take. In the most brilliant way, bananas. And also really funny, really kind. But I mean, it's really difficult because you kind of forget Clara doesn't like Missy because, well, she's the master. She's also kind of responsible for her boyfriend being a sideline. But the problem is working with Michelle. She's so funny. You're sucked in by her because she's really magnetic, and you end up really liking her and keep having to like check yourself. You're like, no, wait, Clara doesn't like you, but you're so funny. So it's that kind of that push and pull.
Are you in the whole series? Can you say that much?
I ain't telling you that.
I thought it was.
I know, and that's